Hey guys, just showing you how I make my wig. Now I like using these weaving caps that I got from Sally's Beauty Supply Store. It's called the Deluxe Multi-Use Weaving Cap. I'm using Jace Beauty Very Coarse Straight. I'll have that, all the hair info in the info box. And I like using weaving caps over spandex caps just because I sew the wigs down and I like to oil my scalp sometimes. So using a weaving cap, you know, I can get to my scalp a little bit better than a spandex cap. Now I sew around the flaps. I do not cut them because the flaps do bend. It's like wire. It's flexible because it's like wire inside the flaps. So they do bend in place. So I like that. So I just sew around them. So I do fold the wefts, and I'm not doubling the wefts this time. I'm doing like one track at a time because I don't want to add too much hair, because this hair tends to get really poofy and big and full. So by doing one track at a time, I can kind of manage how much hair I'm putting on this cap. So this video is really going to be focusing on the front. That area right there is where my natural hair is going to be, like where my natural part is going to be. And I'm just using that mark and sewing the tracks around that area. So I'm laying the tracks like this all the way up to the front because I kind of want the hair to kind of fall in my face. And I got this idea from Ivy's channel. I'm going to put her channel below. The way she lay her tracks right here in the front. I'll put her channel below so you guys can check her video out. She did a full head sew-in, but I'm going to have a little part on the side. So right here, I'm just flipping a track going the other way because I want some volume right here in this area, because I really want this area to have a lot of volume and to fall in my face. So I'm just sewing this track going the other way, and I'm going to flip it back. So I'm just going to take another track and place it going against that one so that it can create the volume. So right here, I'm just laying my checks like an invisible part, like around the hairline area, so I can leave a little bit of my hairline out. And I got this idea from Ivy again. I will post the video below because so you can see exactly how to do it. This is my first time doing it, so I really don't know. But I'm just finishing up this area. I'm gonna have a little bit of my natural hair out, like a little bit, like the smallest leave out ever. So I am done just showing you how it looks, and it might look crazy right now because it's not on my head, but I'm just showing you how the hairline area will look. See how we flip it back and you won't see a track or anything. That's how I want it to look, and I want the hair to kind of fall into in my face because I'm going to layer that area and have curls, and you just see it in about a week or so, week or two. I'm going to install this wig, and I'm going to cut the part where my natural hair is going to be. Please excuse the background in this video because this is my little working area, so it's a little messy in the back. So next I'm going to layer the hair, you know, flat iron the hair, of course, because it is kind of poofy right now. So I'm going to flat iron it, layer the hair, and put some curls in it. And I will be recording that in about a week or so when I install this wig. So all the hair information will be in the description box, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.